Welcome to the Talyllyn Railway's official YouTube channel. Coming up, we have the old lady and the old gent. We find out about the man who came up with a well-known tank engine. Take a look at the big projects the Talyllyn Railway have been undertaking recently. And we speak to the staff and volunteers of the world's first preserved railway. We start the day at Pendray, home of the railway's loco and carriage sheds. The morning starts with the fires being lit in the locomotives, and for one steam engine, the crews are bidding a farewell for what could be a long time. Steam loco number 3, Sir Hayden, is reaching the end of a boiler certificate, which means she will need to have a complete overhaul, and as these kinds of overhauls come at very big prices, it could be some time before Sir Hayden returns to steam. We visit Sir Hayden on one of the penultimate days in steam before overhaul. One of the many projects the railway is in the middle of is returning locomotive number 7, Tom Rolt, to steam. Here she takes a stroll into the yard, looking rather underdressed. Taran Wharf Station is King's licensed cafe and bistro, which offers a wide range of quality food, drinks and snacks for every time of day. The railway shop at Talyllyn Wharf Station stocks a wide selection of transport and historic related items, as well as Talyllyn Railway branded goods. The licensed bar serves a range of beers, wines and spirits, including an ever-changing selection of real ales. The Gauge Railway Museum is based at Talyllyn Wharf Station. We speak to the museum attendant, Winston McKenna, about the fascinating museum.
Well, the Narrow Gauge Railway Museum started in 1952 with this locomotive. The Preservation Society had only just been formed a year or so when the Guinness Brewery in Dublin offered the railway this. It was accepted. It actually took 4 years to get here, but that was the idea for forming a museum. The very first item in the collection to go on show was a restored Talyllyn slate wagon. And since then it's grown from those very small beginnings to the handsome display that we have now. Unfortunately, the early pioneers started early enough that most of these railway systems were operating. And as they slowly, one by one, were taken out of use, we were approached, would you like? And so nearly all of these items here have been donated. And it has formed a collection which is therefore very representative of the narrow gauge railway scene in United Kingdom, in the Isle of Man, and in Ireland.
The museum is also home to the artefacts owned by the Thomas the Tank Engine creator, the Reverend W. Audrey. In the museum is a study lovingly recreated, including his library, writing desk, and typewriter. Also in the study is a map of the island of Sodor, which is home to Thomas and his friends. Over the hill from Tawin, loco number 2, Dolgok, is visiting the Steam, Steel and Stars Gala at Carrick Station. She is giving footplate rides to visitors who have braved the elements to see the steam locomotive Tornado, Britannia, and the Talyllyn's neighbour, Palmerston, from the Festiniog Railway.
Come on. Wharf Pendry Cutting is probably the most heavily used part of the Talyllyn Railway. It's the link between the running sheds and the main passenger station. It was last relaid in 1979-80 when the opportunity was taken to alter the gradient slightly. However, over the last 15 to 20 years we've suffered with severe problems with drainage and a gradual deterioration of the track. Decision was taken therefore that over the winter of 2011-12 we would totally renew the railway in the area. This has involved the relaying of just over a quarter of a mile of track, the installation of half a mile of drainage in a mixture of perforated pipe and troughing, total reballasting and refettling of the cutting slopes. Volunteer effort put into the work was somewhere in the region of 1,000 volunteer days. That gives you an impression of the number of people that worked on the project. We have over 100 names down who have put that time in. The work took from the beginning of November through to round about the end of March, so November 2011 to March 2012. First job was obviously the removal of the track, then we put the track back down in a very temporary condition so that the Christmas train service could be run. Then the cutting drainage was undertaken, a long, slow job. Finally, tamping and lining and level. All in all, a very successful project. Overall cost somewhere in the region of £100,000. The railway identified about 6 or 7 years ago the requirement for additional covered storage for the railway. The site at Pendray is particularly constrained, housing estates either side of it, with little room for expansion. During the winter, we have problems with storing all our rolling stock under cover and leaving space for essential maintenance to be done. We looked around and found that we had sufficient land at Quarry Siding to build a shed approximately 25 metres long by 9 metres wide, which would give us 50 metres of storage space and an annex for materials 25 metres long by 3 metres wide. Numerous design studies were undertaken until we finally came upon the solution for the size of the shed and the design of it. Work was halted for a while we raised the necessary finance. We were lucky in that one of our long-standing members, Phil Guest, who unfortunately died, left the society sufficient money in his will for us to be able to proceed with the project. So last year designs were undertaken, contracts were let for the construction of the shed, and work started on site in September of 2011. Work proceeded over the winter with completion taking place in March. We are very grateful to Phil for leaving us enough money to undertake the work.
Started like a lot of people in the loco department right at the bottom, so I was about 14 years of age when I started, and I'd been to visit the railway when I was 12, and with my family on a typical Welsh holiday, and we'd been to various narrow gauge railways, and one of which was in fact was the Festiniog, which unfortunately on the day we went there was no train running, so we then visited the Talyllyn and the Vale of Rheidol, and I saw these young kids working on the Talyllyn and thought, well, this looks like something I'd like to be interested in. So at that time, volunteers in the local department started at age 14, so I had to wait 2 years. But as soon as I was 14, I managed to have a week away with some friends in Towyn. And we borrowed my parents' caravan, which may or may not have been a good thing, because it was the first time we really stayed away, and there were three people in the caravan all working in the loco department, so the condition of the caravan by the end of the week was not perhaps as good as it could have been. But that was my introduction. I enjoyed it so much that first week that I've never stopped coming back. So through school and university, I did engineering at university, and I was able to spend a lot more time on the railway then. So I used to spend quite a long time in the summer and during my summer vacations. And I also like to get involved in the engineering side of the railway as well. So I didn't just work in the loco department, I did other things, and slowly progressed through the loco department grades. Because the grading system on the Talyllyn works just like British Railways used to do. So we had cleaners and pass cleaners and firemen and pass firemen and so on. And now they let me loose driving the engines. It's always been an extremely friendly railway. It's not quite so perhaps a pressurised existence working on this railway, and there is time to talk and time to, you know, chat with people and so on and meet the public, and I think that's quite an important part of the job, and I think we have probably as much opportunity to do that as anybody, in fact more than most railways, I think. So I think it's the combination of playing with the steam engines and so on, but also the interaction with the public, and the fact that the railway has a very good sort of social life as well. I mean, a lot of people obviously come here just to see their friends and so on, to work on to a common purpose with their friends, and a lot of people, obviously young volunteers who work on the railway, were born long after steam finished on the main line, so they've got no background at all in steam engines, unlike some of the older people like me who, you know, grew up with main lines.
When some tree branches are found near the edge of the railway line, it's the turn of Sir Haydon to come to the rescue, proving there is still a lot of life in the loco yet. Driver Mike Davies and fireman David Martin head out to clear the line.
I've been working on the rowing for 13 years. I first started when I was 14 years old, in October half term. I did a day trip from Leeds when my friend said, why don't you come along today? I was on half term. I came along and I've stuck with it ever since. I never remember making the conscious decision to volunteer on the rowing. My first day was come along, come to the rowing, so I did. I enjoyed it. And I'd spent the day volunteering without actually realising that's what I was doing. It was only then when I thought, actually, I'll go back and do that again, that I realised I'd become a volunteer and become part of the volunteer force. New volunteers are very important to the railway. We always need people to come and help out, and many hands make light work. There's always new jobs to be done, new changing things, and we always need people with different skills to come in and help us out to make sure that the railway is here for future generations. You don't have to like trains to enjoy a trip on the Talyllyn Railway. There's lots of other things to do as well as the ride on the train. And it's not just about the train, it's about the wonderful scenery that the line passes through and all the extra things that you can do when you're here. We're also in the process of rebuilding one of our carriages. We've had to completely rebuild the wooden body of the carriage where the wood had become slightly rotten. We've got another carriage that is currently having a major rebuild done. We've got engine number 3 has its boiler tickets just expired, so that's going to need a lot of work to get that running again. And number 3 is a lovely heritage locomotive. It would be a shame not to see it out again. I've visited many other heritage steam-hauled railways, and I've thought about volunteering on some of them that are nearer to home, but nothing quite compares to the family atmosphere that you find on the Talyllyn. It's a 100-mile drive from my home to here, but on a Friday night, after a week doing my real job, I still love to come down here, and the friendliness of the people and the warm welcome that's here for volunteers and the warm welcome that we extend to all of our passengers. It really is such a friendly railway that I wouldn't ever now think of volunteering anywhere else.
Talyllyn Railway is unique in preservation railway circles. It was, and still is, the first railway to be operated entirely by volunteers. Tom Rolt set up the Talyllyn Railway Preservation Society in 1950, and the Society started operating trains for the first time in May 1951. We have operated trains on the railway ever since, and it's a testament that for over 60 years, volunteers have kept the railway running. The railway also runs through one of the most unspoiled parts of Mid Wales, where there are sandy beaches, beautiful walks, and mountains to climb. So why not come and visit us?
I think that it's got an unbeatable combination, really, of friendly people over here, and the scenery, and the charm, and the history. I think it's a wonderful combination, and the lack of pressure and so on, and the way the railways run, and I think, and also this part of Wales is not as busy as some parts of Wales, so you're not permanently stuck in traffic jams and so on the roads around here. And I think that whole package again, and you know, there's accommodation, there's very good accommodation around here, there's fantastic self-catering, nice places to go out for dinner. I think the combination is again, unbeatable, really.
Talyllyn Railway is the world's first preserved steam railway, and after 146 years continues to provide families a great day out.